भविष्य रात को शराब पिए नाच रहा है डांस कर रहा है.
Roads were empty, that they had to ship in their supporters who could barely reach a number of 500 from Sultanpur and Pratapgarh.
As Rahul Gandhi enters the UP leg of the Bharat Joro Nyay Yatra and he also travelled to Amethi and Raibareli, the big question and also the big suspense, will he or won't he contest from Amethi? Smriti Irani had said, and she had thrown an open challenge to the former MP of Amethi, that if he has the courage, he should muster it and contest the elections against her in 2024. Well, Jairam Ramesh issued a statement which didn't say much, but it also kept the suspense going. He said that the people of Amethi want him to contest, but the final call will be taken by Rahul Gandhi himself and by the Congress party. But there are multiple reasons why many think and why one thinks that indeed Rahul Gandhi must take up this challenge. Well, challenge is the right word. Rahul Gandhi has often insisted that leaders should not shy away from a tough battle. This despite the fact that he himself and the Gandhi Parivar has often been accused of going in for soft battles. Remember when Ajay Makar was made to contest an MLA as well as an MP ticket, it was on the grounds that this was a challenge he must take up even though the odds seemed to be against him. Also, when one of his closest persons, Radeep Surjewala, who was already an MLA from Kethal, was asked to take on a tough fight from Jind and he lost. But never mind is what Rahul Gandhi told him, that it is important that politicians must send out a message that they are not scared to fight. At a time when not many from the Congress party are willing to contest the Lok Sabha elections, and we are being told by sources that Team Rahul as well as many senior leaders feel that some of them like Sachin Pilot, our former chief ministers, Ashok Gehlot, Bhupesh Baghel must take the Lok Sabha plunge but are reluctant to do so. Now if Rahul Gandhi takes up a tough fight in Amethi, then it will send out a message to them that if I can do it, then so can you. But beyond that, Amethi is important because it is one of the star constituencies of Uttar Pradesh. And also, as we know, that the Congress has almost withered away as far as the North Indian states are concerned. After a win in Telangana and a huge government in Karnataka and Telangana, where the Congress lost in Chhattisgarh, in Madhya Pradesh, in Rajasthan, the perception which was built up by the BJP against the Congress party was that it's now just a south-based party. Rahul Gandhi is an MP from Wayanad, his close advisors, for example, KC Venugopal, Jairam Ramesh, all of them are Member of Parliament from South India. Rahul Gandhi speaks a language and a voice which seems to be helping the South Indian cause rather than that of the Northern Belt or North India. In fact, if you remember, when Rahul Gandhi takes pot shots at the Ram Mandir, when the Congress decided not to take part in the Pran Pratishtha, the criticism which went out of the Congress party was that because Ram matters a lot in the North Indian states like UP and Bihar, it didn't really matter to the Congress party. And here is the thing, if Rahul Gandhi decides to contest for an important state of UP, it will at least help counter this perception. UP will always be important to any political party which wants to stake claim for power at the centre. With 80 Lok Sabha seats, can the Congress party afford to give up its chair in Amethi and Raibareli? And therefore this question being asked is that why should Rahul Gandhi then not contest from Amethi? And if he indeed claims, even after he lost in 2019, that Amethi will always remain his home, that it is very important to send out this message to the people of Amethi and Raibareli that even if he has lost once, he is not ready to take the risk of plunge again. And there are these reasons why one thinks that Rahul Gandhi indeed should take up the challenge coming in from Smriti Irani and contest again from Amethi.